I'd like to introduce my husband, John.
John Lennon, president of Apple Records.
I first met Ringo in 39, I think it was. We were in a bomb shelter together, pulling the weed out of John Wayne's hair. Neither one of us was to ever see him again.
With Yoko Ono.
I know you now. 4,000 years. Your body still feels nice and warm to me. The sun is old. The winter's cold. The lake is shining like a drop of Buddha's tear.
When the Beatles were, quote, making their records, and people always presumed that either George Martin or some man was solely responsible or not or whatever. And when each of us started producing our own records, or we took over our own recording sessions, people still couldn't believe that the artist could actually write the song and sing it and possibly go in the studio and make it too. And I went through, and I'm sure many musicians did, went through the same game, which is the mystique of this board here, which is nothing but a tape recorder with a lot of arms on it. And, you know, it's just a matter of telling the engineer what you want. It all comes down to the musician's ear. So when Yoko started doing it too, she got the same jazz on him also. So we'd come in at a session, and she knew what she wanted, whether it was just plain avant-garde or screaming or a pop song. She'd say to the engineer, Charlie, give me more bass. And the engineer turned to me and say, what did you say, John? I said, she said, give me more bass. This went on for 2 years.
Oh, but it was worse in the beginning, you know, because when I stand in front of the mic and start to try to sing or something, all the engineers in the engineer room would just all go to the toilet or something, and suddenly there's nobody there, nobody, so, you know, it couldn't be recorded.
I was always there.
yes.
Joseijoi Banzai, Joseijoi Banzai, Joseijoi Banzai.
you tell them all this about?
Well, it's about, I got a letter from a Japanese female labor organization, and they asked me to write a feminist song for them. And because they really didn't have a song to sing in meetings and such. So I wrote the song, and of course it's about 2,000 years of male society, and they didn't do very much to improve a society or anything. On the contrary, the world is just about to blow up, and there's pollution and all that, and it's a terrible world. So it's about time that men would resign from their positions and starting to think in terms of exchanging roles with women, you know. It's
death of Samantha is that like the death of your soul, isn't it?
Yes.
For one moment it cuts out.
Well, whenever you don't say what you want to say, whenever you don't do what you want to do, that's when you're dying, you know.
of something in the English papers about groups of women in England wearing half masks
and
attacking men on the street and robbing them. And I don't know about molesting them, but they were actually mugging them. And Yoko had already started writing this, the Rosies are coming to get you kind of song. And then she read this about
it. It was really sort of strange, you know, it's like telepathy. I don't know what it is, but it was like more than coincidence, I think. And anyway, Catman is one of the songs that I like very much.
Catman, shine in your tools today, they say. Catman, Catman, my name is Rosie and my hand's on you. Catman, Catman, so you fly high gold and your banana skin. Burn your handy sand, give you a bug. Squeeze your lemon and give you a mug. Cut your daisy skin, give you a slug. And don't be too brave or we'll blow your silly sour.
Song that I wrote in a farmhouse, really, when John and I went to a farmhouse. So we sort of accidentally went to a farmhouse. We're looking for a place for us to stay on the weekend and in the suburbs of New York. It was a beautiful farmhouse and without any heat or no nothing. It was cold and but beautiful, you know, and the moon was shining and everything. And anyway, so I wrote it then. And it's sort of obvious that, you know, it's sort of like a song that came out of our life or my life or whatever. But it was that kind of isolated farmhouse that made me think.
Yoko used to, or probably still does, but less so, because I'm, quotes, John Lennon, and also can be a problem to live with. Well, so can she, because we're both artists. But she tended to write when I was asleep, you know, or when I wasn't there, although I was sort of, you know, understanding and, yes, I'm with you all the way, but tend out, just don't do it when I'm around. You know, I'm the writer, although I never expressed it in words. So she found herself, like a lot of women, which is doing things on the side, you know, and things like Winter Song, which I particularly like, was written at dawn because the pig was asleep, and probably that was the only chance she got to do it. And it has a very delicate quality, and some lyrics that I wish I had written myself. Have two choices, either work together or work apart. That's presuming they're both creative, like the film stars we used to read about, like, you know, Betty Lou would be in South America making a film with Tarzan, and Errol Flynn would be in the moon making a film with Joan Crawford or whatever it was. And all those fell apart somehow, no matter how devoted they might be, because nobody can survive being apart. So we have that choice, either survive as human beings and still create, or separate so as neither of our creative energies or images impose on the other. And we've opted for living together.
What do you do?